Welcome to the reopening day of SeaWorld here in Orlando. It is opening day. Literally, it just opened like 2 hours ago. So let's just go see what safety measures they are taking here at SeaWorld to kind of give you guys an idea of if it's a place that you would like to come visit and if you would feel safe for all the measures that they are taking. So if you want to see what it's like at SeaWorld, then stay tuned and let's go.
It helps that I'm 2 hours after the park has opened. Because I saw people here earlier and it was all the way out here. Yep, looks like I'm just gonna get to roll on in. Hello, SeaWorld.
Here's our first signage for temperature screening. Guests with 104 or 100.4 and above will not be let in. It looks like we go through this little tent here first for the temperature screening. Social distancing, clean your hands. Face coverings are required for guests ages 2 and older. And modified seating and capacity limitations for the rides and for the shows. So we'll see how that looks when we get in there. They have a hand sanitizer station here. 6 feet markings. Hello.
Welcome back.
Thank you. Hello. Am I good? Am I good? Thanks. As soon as you exit, there's another thing to get some sanitizer. Why not? Gotta keep sanitized, right? They have the line spaced out here to go through security with the markers on the ground here as well. I always have to show my bag. Hello! Got a barrier here. Still gotta lean in to give them my bag though. Here's the line of everybody trying to get in. It looks like a whole lot of people, but everybody is staying on their social distancing markers there. If you missed when we passed by the ticket booth, they do have more hand sanitizer right here. I'm on my marker. They're like in the middle. Oh, they are on a marker. I can move up. The only thing with parties is that everybody's not up by their marker. So like that lady is, but the end of her party is still back here. So I can't really go to that spot right there and be 6 feet away. So I kind of just gotta stay where I am.
There were a lot of parties that did that at Universal as well. So it's not a knock at SeaWorld guests.
They do have this plastic screen here, but as you can see, the employee is still coming around to the side. So it's not really serving much of a purpose. She's not hiding behind it or anything. Maybe the tickets weren't scanning behind the protective plastic. Upon entering, more sanitization stations. That dude's vlogging. There are enter here, one-way stickers onto the gift shop. I want to see if I can find some of the SeaWorld specific masks. Oh, there they are. Buy three, get one free masks. You can be a dolphin, a shark. What is that? They got these flamingos here. That one's really cute. And then these monkeys. Since it's buy three, get one free, I got one of each except for the one that I didn't know what the heck that animal was. If I find the penguin one later, I'm totally getting the penguin. Trying to maneuver the gift shop to get out, people. Dog, hi doggy. Okay, oh, it's very hard to not. Where's the exit? Exit, one way, enter. Crap, how do I get out of here? Avoiding people. All right, time to switch from this lame mask to the dolphin. I'm gonna pick the dolphin. Let's do it. I'm a happy dolphin. I'm a happy dolphin. You guys have an awesome day to hang out in the pool. It's pretty hot today. If you click on the app and you go to schedules, they do have the schedule of all the shows today. But if you click on wait times, ride wait times only appear during regular operating hours. SeaWorld, you guys are open. Where are your ride times? I came into another gift shop to see if they have the penguin mask. But just so you know, they also have youth masks if you need some for your kids. But same ones here.
Also, I feel like I've already stretched this out a little bit because I feel it was tugging on my ears when I first put it on. You see, I was all ready for a penguin mask. I got my penguin earrings on and everything. You can't see it, but I'm doing a sad face.
I'm gonna be honest though, these little signs here telling people exit only, do not enter into the gift shops. Yeah, nobody's paying attention to those. It's fairly spread out here, not a lot of people. This is actually where the Pets Ahoy show usually is, at the Seaport Theater. But instead of the time slot, it's just a park map.
So I guess no Pets Ahoy show right now.
Look at this SeaWorld squirrel. I'm so close to him, look. He's not afraid of me. I think he's gonna come get me. Okay, squirrel, good luck on your food finding adventures. Have a good day. Okay, bye.
So it's fairly spaced out over here. This is a wide little area, but areas that are close or are narrow, people kind of aren't paying attention, at least where the ones I've gone down. People are not paying attention in those pathways, and their parties are just all over the place. So I don't know if it's a difference between SeaWorld and Universal Guests, but I feel like people were a little bit more mindful of others at Universal. Granted, there were some people. I have people here to the left of me about to pass me that both of them have their mask down around their face or down by their mouth. So, do you see them? They don't have their masks on. Like, put your masks on. It's not that hard. Now, I don't want to sound like I'm being a super complaining person, but masks are required unless you are eating. You know, eating or drinking something, and then put your mask back on. Here, here's another one. Mask completely off here to the left of me. I don't get it. Do you guys get it? If you don't want to wear a mask, then don't go to a place where masks are required. Go to a place where masks are suggested but not required. But come to SeaWorld or come to Universal or come to Disney and actually abide by the rules. I don't think it's that hard, do you?
We got 25 minutes until the Dolphin Day show. So let's go see how they have everything spaced out in there and go see some dolphins. Right here, before you break off to go right or left up the ramp, they have more hand sanitizer here. So far I've seen a lot of hand sanitizer. That waterfall is relaxing.
All right, here you got signs, exit, do not enter. So I have to go over to the left to get into any of these rows. They also have stickers on the benches here. So they're social distancing the benches. Looks like they have markers here so that your party is separate. I am sitting in the reserved seating though.
SeaWorld upgraded every one of their pass holders to the next level. So now I have the highest pass you can get, which means that you have reserved seating for all the shows.
But at least for today, it looks like as long as you get here early, I mean, that's not reserved over there and there's still plenty of seating.
I'm so excited. I've never been this close to the dolphins before.
Hopefully it doesn't start pouring on us. Looks like rain. I hear the dolphins squeaking. I see them. I'm so excited. 12 more minutes.
I don't know why people think because they're sitting down for a show, it means to take your mask off. Because like almost everybody around me is not wearing their mask right now.
You guys can see how everybody's spaced out. Also get an idea of how many people are and aren't wearing their masks. Quite a few people here. Everybody looks like they're kind of on their marker, but some people are closer than they should be.
And we got 7 minutes before the show starts. I'm gonna forget about what everybody else is doing. You guys can see from the video who is doing social distancing and who is and isn't wearing their mask. I'm gonna have an awful day if I keep nitpicking and getting mad at everybody not following the rules. So I'm gonna have a good day. So let's have a good day, okay?
Excuse me, sir. I don't think you're supposed to be in this exhibit. If so, you're a one weird looking dolphin. He took the hit. Bye.
When will I get out of here? Okay.
That next row can stand up in the very back, and you get up to the back. My friends down here, the first row in front of that pink flag, you guys can exit off this way. Thanks for coming, everybody.
Yes, our turn has come.
First.
Oh, did you hear the thunder?
It feels like there is thunder in the area.
Ah! Just stay where you are, undercover.
Shelter while this storm passes. So if you want to stay here, you may very well.
Sanitize on the way out. Oh, that's really liquidy. There's a storm. Either it's just gonna pass by us, or it's gonna pour in about 5 minutes, and I have no umbrella.
Because I came prepared. So exiting shows is gonna prove very problematic because people can't follow directions. People are impatient. I said I wasn't gonna be negative anymore, but this is straight up.
Weather and lightning in the immediate area. All outdoor shows, attractions, and rides have been temporarily suspended.
Uh-oh.
Please seek shelter quickly and safely.
Seek shelter, guys!
We recommend enjoy.
Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, it's not me being critical, it's just straight up observation. People are not paying attention. They wanna get out. Some of them, you know, maybe some people have kids and their kids are like, Mom, I really have to pee. I don't quite know how this whole show thing is going to work. And people were not distanced enough. They had like every other row, but I still felt like I was way too close to people.
We're gonna go see some underwater dolphins, and I feel like SeaWorld is doing the absolute best they really can. Here's the in, here's the out. Here's some, is that bleach? where's the pump? But they are doing the best job that they can. It's just up to us, guys. It's up to people. We need to make sure we're distanced from everybody.
We need to pay attention to the markers on the ground that you stand with your party to maintain 6 feet, like this.
Right here. See, there's a sticker here and here. But if you're in between, you can't really go up there because you're not 6 feet. Also, the dog is here. Hey guys. I wondered what they were gonna do for Stingray Lagoon because you literally touch stingrays. So it's all roped off here.
We've already said on my channel I can't dance. But how do you resist this music?
Hey pelicans! Are you ready for the rain? I have a feeling it's coming. Listen to the epic music outside of Manta! It says 25 minute wait, but everything shut down because of thunder in the area, so all these people are just gonna be hanging out in there for who knows how long. Hey, flamingos! Hi! Something's happening there. Okay, turning away. They need privacy. You got a bad itch. I wish I could help. A child literally came over there, past that, and stopped right here. This is where I'm standing. Stopped right here and then went away. All this open space behind me, but no, a small child comes right up next to me.
Like I said, guys, maintaining social distancing is all up to us. It is up to you parents. It is up to you kids to listen to your parents. Just stay away from me.
Social distancing. Let's go back to the left and see if we can go to Sesame Street. The Seafire Grill is closed, huh? Please visit Voyagers, Expedition, or Spice Mill. People are hanging out. Hey, it's that crazy Disney lady. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everyone. It's always good to see everybody.
Yeah, good to see you too. Have fun.
Bye.
Hydration. Man, it feels so nice not to have the sun on me though, I'll say that. I figured we could take the bridge over to Sesame Street so that we can see what it looks like for the new roller coaster, Icebreaker. This with the music? It's relaxing. There's the Icebreaker coaster. I think it's going to be fun. It does go over there too. So how much more construction do they have to do on that thing? This Icebreaker ride comes over here into our path. Oh man, this is going to create a traffic jam. People are going to stop to watch people go up there, then shoot backwards. All right, let's see how things are in Sesame Street land. So for just upon entering, there's nobody here. There's a character meet and greet with Oscar the Grouch. I guess it's gonna be a regular occurrence because they have markings here on the road. So maybe there's gonna be a different character to meet every day. Hi, Oscar. How are you doing? Staying safe? I see you're up there in your trash can to stay away from everybody. Do your social distancing.
6 feet above everybody.
6 feet above everybody, good job. Oscar didn't have a mask on. I was curious because you had that meet and greet with Oscar. I wondered, usually Cookie Monster and Elmo meet here, and you see there is no meet and greets.
I got scared for a second. I thought I was going out and in, but I'm good.
Elmo forgot this one thing. Be right back.
Elmo will have no snack now.
Okay, Elmo's got his water and he's ready to...
I didn't do it. It wasn't me.
Mom?
I was wondering if people were going to be socially distanced over here because of all the kids. There are no kids.
It's just me. Welcome to Sesame Street with Berger.
B is for Berger. Nom 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 nom.
Hand sanitizer. The explanation for there being nobody over here, the rain. The rides still aren't open, so nowhere to go over here.
I love all this music.
I hope you sanitized your hands before you went to eat that cookie, Cookie Monster.
So other than the few social distancing markers that we saw on the ground over in Sesame Street, there's not really any added markings on the ground over by like the interactive parts where the kids play. So I think once it's actually busy and the rides are open and there's kids back there, it's gonna be pretty busy because they're just gonna be wandering around and there's no little markers to tell them where to go.
I took cover. Because the rain finally came. Actually feels really nice though. I just don't want to get you guys wet.
Now to end the video and my final thoughts. Coming from seeing opening weekend at Universal, SeaWorld really needs some help. Or in all honesty, SeaWorld guests need some help in realizing where they should and shouldn't be. I had multiple times where I was on my designated little circle to maintain 6 feet away from everybody, and I would have small children come right up next to me. I'm not trying to be mean, it's just a straight up observation. Lots of people were running around the park with masks either like this or just completely off their face. They're just walking around without a mask, without a care in the world. Obviously the app needs some help getting back into the swing of things because the wait times for the rides weren't even on there the entire time I was here. And distancing in the shows. We saw a couple people that weren't distancing during the dolphin show and they didn't have their masks on. So lots of problem areas here at SeaWorld. Overall, I love SeaWorld in itself as a company. They do amazing things, but all the guests that I've seen today, come on guys, we can do better. So if you were contemplating of going to Universal or SeaWorld, I would say hold off on going to SeaWorld for a little while. So if you enjoyed this perspective on the opening day of SeaWorld, please remember to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and until next time with another helping of a burger with everything.